Today, we are reviewing Orbit 13 Vaporwave, the new album, a part of the Orbit series, released by Novatone. I made a video about their previous Orbit compilation that was centered around making a hyperpop track. Mainly, the video was meant to be kind of a joke. I honestly listen to hyperpop 5% of the time. But with this next one, I wanted to approach it in a critical tone, just kind of change things up. More of a review style instead of just oohs and ahs for every track. I've already listened to all 20 tracks ahead of this video, and it's time to discuss about Vaporwave. Vaporwave being such an interesting niche genre known for its chill production, hypnagogic artworks, and your local shopping mall background ambience, makes it a really cool and creative challenge to put your own spin on this microgenre of EDM. If you know what Vaporwave is, you know the album that popularized it by Macintosh Plus, aka Vextroid. In fact, Vextroid has released numerous works of the genre in different aliases. Macintosh Plus, Laserdisc Visions, and New Dreams Limited are some of these examples. And that's something I find really cool in Orbit 13, is that there are some artists that vaporize, if you will, themselves into a separate alias for their tracks, like Zovi coming in as Windows 3.11111, or even better, Vapordave. That's right, guys, Vapordave. Making their debut on Novatone Orbit. Can you believe it? I've been waiting for like ever. The titles as well are vaporized. I'll stop. Such as Interstellar Hotline, Dream Shop, Telescope, and BIENVENIDOS a Green Acres Mall. I think I botched that up badly. Back to the roots of the genre, another concept of it has been to sample other music and incorporate it by lowering pitch, looping, distortion, heavy reverb, and most importantly, paint a picture, which is kind of how it kind of displays through the artworks. Like Convexity and FRIX track, Interstellar Hotline, in my mind is a faint daydream of a karaoke night at a nightclub in the 80s. That's how you vaporwave. Lots of tracks pull off this effect, such as Whitetail, VA Cola, DeBisco, Blank Ambition, DJKiske, Adamo, 92 Vagabond, and Skeleton Lipstick, who actually produces Vaporwave as his main genre. Simple things such as glitches and panning happen later on more frequently, and work like a charm with artists Zovi and Pulvite's tracks. The ambient tracks in between the album, like the Shoji one, serves as flawless transitions from one idea to another. Real Clothes has got to be my personal favorite, with what I assume is the intercom ringing with announcements interrupting the Spanish mall music in a Spanish mall. I don't, like that's how creative and niche this genre is. It really makes you think with your imagination. That's how you vaporwave. The songs running at a longer length, including the Hideyoshi track and the DJKiske track, go as far as I like long tracks. Good ideas, nice vibe, you know. I would say both of them are pretty groovy, but maybe just a little shorter was preferable here, in just my general opinion. I will also add, I appreciate and actually do find it really funny, the comedic aspect taken by TRAELMYX in Catmaid Plaza, with a bunch of cats meowing throughout the track. And the other thing is, and I will say this is comedic, but like in internet terms, it's just plain meme-y, with Pulvite from her remix of Convexity's The Motive. And there's just, the samples are just there. And, you know, there are some actually like good nostalgic samples of like old commercials and stuff, you know, like that's cool. But like with the random memes thrown in there, it just adds just a little bit of comedy to it, which is nice. And those last 30 seconds like scared me. Like it was just out of nowhere. It was just so loud. But at the end of the day, I got to give credit to the remaining people who knocked this on the head by infusing other EDM genres. Yonvolt's influence of hardcore and hard side to the track was a surprising twist, considering the album is almost finished when we get to her track. And the catchiest goes to Onirio 98 on his track Back and Forth Dreams. I caught some glimpses of what was possibly Neurostep, Moombahcore, and or Glitch Hop. I think the heaviness wasn't forced or a last minute idea thrown in. It felt like it just fit. And also, I've never heard a heavy song fade out before, but I'm not hating. I think I've said what I need to say about this album. I fully recommend this and the rest of the Orbit albums to anyone that likes EDM in general. The recent editions have specialized in specific microgenres and styles, some ranging experimentally, but I'm sure there's something for everyone. You like house? Boom! Orbit 6, house. More of a dubstep person? They made one on rhythm. They have even put out one on Psytrance. So, Yeah, just check them out. Like, they're not even at 1,000 followers, and they, like, work super, super hard. But yeah, did you like this? Did you not? What were your favorite tracks? Let me know. This has been a review I've probably put the most effort into. So if there's anything I can improve on, feel free to holler. And yeah, thank you for watching. Oh, and last thing, join the Novatone Discord server. Go check it out. I will see you in the next video.